There has been information about the expiry of the Inspector General of Police, John Martin Okoth-Ochola's contract for the past few days, which has sparked debates at Nenaguru Police Headquarters, with a number of high-ranking officers vying to occupy the position. Police spokesperson Freddie Nanga has, however, refuted claims of infighting within the force. He, however, confirms that Ochola's contract is indeed expiring soon. Enanga further notes that the position of the IGP is a highly prestigious position and thus cannot just be given out to anyone not befitting.
We are continuously speculating over the contract of the Inspector General of Police. We want to inform the public that it is true the contract of the IGP, Mr. John Martin Okoth-Ochola, will end on the 4th of March 2024. As always, the police usually gets information coming from a number of peddlers and propagandists who always speculate over this position on as to whether the contract is going to be renewed or there's going to be a new appointment of the Inspector General of Police.
Meanwhile, following the arrest of four fishermen by Congolese security forces a few weeks ago, the Congolese authorities have finally agreed to hand over the fishermen to the Ugandan authorities. Uganda police spokesperson Fred Enanga disclosed that the two countries held talks over the weekend in Kasese and an agreement was reached at to hand over the four fishermen that were abducted from Lake Edward.
To inform the public that Uganda and DRC agreed to cooperate better amidst exchange of fishermen arrested on Lake Edward. The Ugandan and DRC officials held productive talks on the 9th of February 2024 at around 1 p.m. at the UPDF Marines offices at Katwe Kabatoro. That is in Kasese district.
Also, police from Mukono arrested a hacker who was behind the theft of money from dozens of mobile money subscribers. Sabiti Kaporonyo, 48 years, is said to have made millions of shillings by simply hacking into the accounts of mobile money subscribers.
So we want to thank the Crime Intelligence Task Team and police from Mukono CPS who managed to arrest a one called Kaporonyo Sabiti, aged 48, a hacker from Namugongo here in Wakiso, on allegations of hacking into mobile money systems of agents and dealers and stealing money from their agent lines. The suspect made millions of shillings from hacking into these mobile money systems and stealing money from agents in Mukono, Jinja Misindie, Chira Division.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Internal Affairs has revealed that less than 3% of Ugandans own passports. Ministry of Internal Affairs spokesperson Simon Mundei said since 2018, when the country started issuing electronic passports, only 1.3 million Ugandans have applied for the passports.
Only 1,346,560 e-passports have been issued, inclusive of both paper-based and polycarbonate-based passports. We have a population of about 45 million Ugandans. Here we are. We have only issued passports to 1.3 million Ugandans. Many Ugandans only apply for passports if they have a reason to do it. Many of them haven't applied for passports. So we have about almost 43 million Ugandans without passports.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.